Hi friends, this is Anjali from Vyans Medical Academy. Today I would like to discuss about animal husbandry. Do you know friends what is animal husbandry? What is the role of this? Animal husbandry is an agriculture practice raising breeding livestock. It includes buffaloes, cows, sheep, cattle, etc. However, the term livestock is often used to farm animals. It includes since the time immemorial animals like prawns, crabs, silkworms, honeybees, etc. They give an additional employment and an income to mainly in rural areas. World's livestock population in India and China together more than 70%, but world's productivity of India is less than 25%. Indian annual milk per eel 170 liters per cow. But in Netherlands annual milk per eel 4100 liters per cow. Because of this Indian low productivity, Indian cow is known as teacup cow. The lecture flow like this: management of farm, dairy farm management, poultry farm management, beekeeping, fishery, animal breeding, moid. Coming to the dairy farm management, breeding, feeding and management of milk animals, processing, production, marketing of milk products is dairying. Some animals have used in different purpose like Holstein Friesian. Do you know friends? This cow give 30 liters per day. Red Dane, Brownsies, Sahiwal, Red Sindhi, Deoni, drought breeds. This can be used only for work purpose. Malvi, Halikar, Nageri, Kangayam. General utility breeds. These used also dual purpose. Haryana, Kankraj, Tapakar. Dairy farm management includes selection of good breeds, disease resistance animals, feed and water management in scientific manner. Regular checkup by veterinary doctor to rectify several diseases. Let us move on poultry farm. Poultry farm means it is a class of domesticated birds reared for meat or eggs or both. It includes chickens, peafowls, geese, turkey, etc. Chickens are two types, broilers and layers. Broilers are only raised for meat. Layers are only raised for eggs. And next move on to apiculture. Apiculture or beekeeping. Beekeeping is the maintenance of hives of honeybees for the production of honey and honey wax. In India, they are widely used to honeybees. They are Apis mellifera. It produces large quantity and quality of honey. Apis indica. It is a wild and it is also domesticated. Economic importance of honeybees. Honey, it is a rich source of sucrose. Wax, it is used to prepare cosmetics. Propolis, it is used to treatment of inflammation. Bee venoms, it is used to treatment of arthritis. Pollination. Do you know friends, bees are the best pollinators. It can be pollinated grassica, apple, pear. And next coming to fishery. Fishery means fishery is an industry or occupation devoted to the catching, processing for the storage in freezers and selling of fish. Fishes are living both marine water and fresh water. Marine water fishes are hilsa, sardine, bombay duck, mackerel, pomfret, salmon. Freshwater fishes are katla, mrigala, labia, rohita. Uses of these fishes are, do you know friends, fish is a good delicious food. In a fish meat, a good source of vitamin A and D. Fish guano, it is a fertilizer obtained from scrap fish. Icing glass, it is a fertilizer obtained from dried swim bladders of mostly in catfish. It is used to clarification of wines. Shark liver oil and cod liver oil. It has a rich source of vitamin A and D obtained from salmon and sardine. Salmon and sardine have rich source of omega-3 fatty acids. It have prevent the several bacteria and disease resistance like prevent the cancer cell growth and etc. And next coming to the most important topic, animal breeding. Animal breeding is divided into inbreeding, outbreeding. Inbreeding means cross between closely related animals within 4 to 6 generations. Cross between superior male bubalus and superior female vas indicas. It produces a progeny, it gives 25 liters milk per day. Outbreeding. Outbreeding is divided into 3 types. Outcross, crossbreeding, intraspecific hybridization. Outcross. Outcross means cross between different species, different related species or same breeds without any ancestors in 4 to 6 generations. For example, Ongole bull and Punjab cow cross between different breeds. For example, Bikaneri ewes and Merino rams. It produces, hazardly, it is a sheep, produce more wool. Intraspecific hybridization. Intraspecific hybridization means cross between different species, for example, male donkey, female horse. Cross between these two animals, we produce mule. Male horse and female donkey, cross between these two animals, we produce hinni. And next, the most important topic, moit. Moit means multiple embryo multiple ovulation embryo transfer and technology. In this process, select a female superior cow and administrator the hormones FSH, like it induces super ovulation. Instead of one egg, it produces 6 to 8 eggs. After superior ovulation mate with allied bull or artificial insemination, it can be formed 6 to 8 zygotes are formed. At these zygotes are in 8 to 32 cellular stage. These zygotes can recover non-surgically and transfer into 7 surrogate mothers. Uses of this moit is increasing heart size in a short time. And friends, continuous inbreeding leads to depression. It is called inbreeding depression. To recover this depression, cross with different species like outcross. Advantages of inbreeding is increasing homozygosity. Friends, this is the most important topic and easy to learn. We get one question from this chapter. I hope you understand my lecture. Vyas Medical Academy wishes to you good luck for your NEET exam.